someone were also extremely effective in whipping up support for the war. Okay, we'll fix the link. And if you get a chance this week, it takes 15 minutes. It's really interesting to look at. Again, we don't have a lot of time. Very quickly, in the recent years, you begin to see a reaction to the notion of objectivity. It's always been Morris Ernst, the left writer of the 30s, writes, the question is not whether the news shall be unprejudiced, but whose prejudice is of color the news. 1923, Henry Luce creates Time magazine, which is for the first, until the 1960s really, an incredibly influential publication in American life politically. It still has a role, but it was a dominant publication. Strongly anti-communist, for a while ambivalent about Hitler, then finally anti-Nazi, and creating this colorful style, the punning headlines that you see in every magazine now, from the New Republic to National Review to The Atlantic and so on, those all begin there, a certain style of writing, a narrative style where you tell stories, a language Marshall McLuhan said about the style of Time magazine in which nobody could tell the truth. Creating a style of interpretive journalism, that's very much a part of what goes on with us. In recent years, you begin to see people actually saying, look, objectivity is impossible. You might as well just have people forget about objectivity. And this is important, particularly, maybe I'll come back as we talk about new media, but this is where this really comes up. In the new media, do we want objectivity, or do we just want bloggers from every point of view, so, you know, real report, you decide. But let's take that up later in the semester, because it's going to go down now. Up next time, very quickly. Oh, shoot. You want to say something about baseball?